When it comes to Internet of Things and you want to control your devices over the internet, ESP modules is an excellent choice.
One of the most common ESP modules are ESP32, ESP01 and ESP8266. In ESP01, the number of input-output pins are very less. It has only two input-output pins, but if you are not using it as serially, so you can use TX-RX pin as well.
Let's have a comparison between ESP8266 and ESP32. ESP8266 has a single core processor, rather ESP32 has dual core processor. But one of the salient features in ESP32 is ESP32 has a conventional Bluetooth as well as a BLE, which support low energy devices as well.
To program ESP modules, you can use Arduino software, but for that you need to follow some of the steps. First of all, click the link in the description and download the zip file from the GitHub and open the README file. After that, open the README file and click the link and paste it in the preference bar, and then open the board manager and type it ESP. Now, according to your requirement, download ESP32 or ESP8266 module. After that, click on tools and now you can select any module from ESP32 or ESP8266. After connecting ESP module, you have to select the COM port, but sometimes it does not occur in the list. For that, first of all, you can try a different data cable, but if it is not working, so you have to install the driver. Now you can open the folder with the name of troubleshooting software. Basically, the chip comes with two different options, CH34X or CP210X. There is written on the chip on your ESP module, but it is very small. So I would suggest to install CH34X first. And if your problem is solved, so that's fine. Otherwise, install CP210X driver. While installing CP210X driver, when you open the folder, you have two options. You can install the driver for Windows with 64 bits or 32 bits. Install it according to your system requirement. After connecting the circuit diagram, upload the basic blink code for ESP8266. In ESP8266, the built-in LED is connected on the D4 pin, so that's why I have declared LED as D4. And then select the correct board, which is NodeMCU 1.0 ESP12E module. And after that, select the COM port and then just press the button to upload the code. The built-in LED on ESP32 board is connected to the pin number 2, so we will declare LED as pin number 2, but the difference is we need to write it as LED equal to 2, not DIT. And then we will select the correct board, which is in our case DOIT ESP32 DevKit V1, and then we will select the COM. In ESP32, the code will not upload directly. You need to press the boot button while uploading the code. But if you don't want this option, you can connect the 10 microfarad electrolytic capacitor with enable and your GND pin. The bigger leg goes into enable and the smaller one goes into GND. After uploading the code, just press the enable button once.